pictures and videos are actually images of people, images of people. There are clones of people, images of people living, and then there are images of people, and they are actually, one can store them, one can save them as vibrant images of people that one knows and that one has met, or that one has taken part in life. And they're actually very, very important. They're actually very, very important status symbols of life, symbols of existence, evidence of our existence on Earth. That's why if they are not put in order, if they are not put alphabetically in order, in alphabetically and numerically in order, the numerics, you know, have you got the buzz? You know, numerics, have you got the numerics? But the infinite buzz, you know, if they're not put in terms of calendar, in terms of days and months and dates and names and in alphabetical numerical order, they confuse somebody, they can make anybody mark. That's why we've got these APC 123 system. There are atomic, biological and chemical weapons, and that's why they can make you mad. You know, they can make you, if you don't have your pictures in order, if you don't have your pictures and videos in order, you can get mad. You can get so mad that you can injure your own family, your own neighbors, your own acquaintances, your own colleagues, your own friends. You can injure them, and that is actually the problem with pictures and videos. That if you don't have them in order, they can destroy your whole life. They can stop you from moving unless they are put back in order. And that is why I always work on pictures and videos in the internet. Especially what I do is I order them according to rooms. Like my family is also a unit. A room is a unit, an SI unit, and a family room is a family SI unit. Be it an apartment or a villa or a mansion or a home or a house, or whatever you call it. But what I do is I begin by ordering them in terms of the single unit of the person who is involved in the unit, on the name, and then I do that according to the number that it gives me, all these family members and friends, relatives, friends and acquaintances and colleagues, and then that way I'm able to find out how the person looks like on the landscape, in the landscape, in the puzzle. I'm able to set a puzzle. And that is why I do a lot of images with pictures, and videos. And that is that prevents what you can get. For example, is if you don't have the pictures in order, you can get a disease called schizophrenia. It is the trans identity, the trans culture, the trans activism, trans what do you call it, and trans fetishism, where you will think that you are talking to, where you think that you are somebody else, like, or some other soul, and you are the same person who's in that problem, that cannot find your way around your environment, which is that you are another environment, but you are actually that topic, in the sense that you talk and you communicate and you listen and you answer and you converse and you get questions and answers, and that is actually that word. When somebody asks you a straight question, you can give a straight answer. When somebody asks you when somebody has a puzzle, if somebody is puzzled, you can solve the puzzle for a person. Somebody says that person, he or she is puzzled, for example, you can solve that puzzle by asking about why the person is puzzled, or what the puzzle, or what kind of puzzle the person is puzzled about. And that is actually the schizophrenia therapy of being able to do that by easily solving the puzzle. For example, be it a normal crossword puzzle or a normal, like, crossword puzzles can, of course, there are normal, there are simple, and there are advanced crossword puzzles. Schizophrenia is an advanced crossword puzzle, which once you solve it, you can solve it in easy times, in an easy sentence. For example, that 2000. 70-1 in case of a normal mathematical equation. But if it is, for example, questions about people, you can say that 16 is equal to 70-1. That means that the person is 16. Or it is equal to 1 plus 15. That means that the person is 16, for example. And that is, for example, a cryptic puzzle, an advanced cryptic puzzle, which you can solve by providing pictures, sample pictures of people who correspond to that image. And those are images, pictures, and videos which you can find, which you can find and put them each across the puzzle, fill in all the puzzle, and then leave people to find solutions. People going to this world, people are familiar with such images to find solutions for such images. And that is actually a cryptic puzzle, for example. That is how I solve cryptic puzzles. Chess puzzles, complicated chess puzzles. Once you've got the chessmen in place, you can always move them and wait for somebody else to free your minds, or by thinking aloud, or whatever it might be. You can do that.